is Sarah. I'm one of the physios here at the Sick Children's Hospital. And thank you for coming today, Lindsay, with your daughter Abbey, to show us how we check and treat for hip dysplasia.
What is hip dysplasia?
So hip dysplasia is when the hip joint is more shallow than it should be.
Do all babies get checked for hip dysplasia?
So yeah, they do. So all babies get an examination of the newborn within just a couple of days of their birth, and one of the things they check for at that point is hip dysplasia. Depending on the outcome of that, then there's certain things that might then initiate them being referred for a secondary screen, such as being breech or a family history. So when we assess a baby's hips, we look at the way that a baby is lying, and we look to make sure they're lying nice and symmetrically and in the middle. We then check their range of movement at their hips and make sure that their hips stretch right out. We would always do these checks with the nappy off, but today for the filming we're keeping the nappy on. We would also have a look at their skin creases and check for any differences there. And then we check the movement of the hip in the terms of the stability of the hip by doing a gentle press and stretch out of the hip. And we do that on the other side as well. And these are the tests that tell us whether these hips are normal or not normal.
How does the harness treat the hip dysplasia?
So what it does is it holds the hip in a good position and stops the baby moving in that abnormal direction. And as they do and they kick and wriggle, because the hip is made of cartilage, it will remodel and it will deepen and become a normal hip joint again.
So as she develops and she grows, she's not going to be kind of limited in any way? It's not going to hurt her?
No, and it doesn't affect their development in the longer term. So Abby is wearing a pelvic harness, so let's get that off and see how her hips are doing today.
Okay. The first evening when it was on her, she would cry for an hour, but then she got used to it. I think she, as the baby, adapted better than perhaps what me and my husband did.
Absolutely, and that's very common, is the babies adapt very, very quickly, and the harness doesn't cause them any pain either.
We don't quite realise how much the harness kind of impacts later on, like holding her, feeding her, even changing a nappy, but within a few days, kind of adapted to it, so.
So just check and have a little check of her movement, and make sure these hips are stretching out how we need them to be. And a little check of her skin. Sometimes it can be tricky getting in to check the skin and clean the skin, can't it?
Yes. I know with Abby, I was told that she would have to wear the harness for up to 12 weeks. Is that kind of the same for all babies that have hip dysplasia?
Yeah, but usually between 8 and 12 weeks.
Okay.
It's very important that the parents carry out the instructions that the clinician has given them on how to use the harness. So it stays on all the time. It's just very important, particularly in those early stages when that hip is moving around, that it stays on to keep it in a good position.
So basically, I can't take it off as a parent, not even for bath time, huh?
No, right now.
When she soils her nappy and it unfortunately goes on the harness, or she regurgitates or some other accident, how do you clean the harness?
Yeah, so sometimes if there's just a little bit on the harness, you can give it a little scrub with an old toothbrush and give it a clean that way. Or sometimes wrapping just some elastoplast tape around the strap is enough to cover it over.
Okay.
But if she's very dirty, then we ask you to give us a call and we'll arrange fitting a clean one for her.
Okay.
All right. Okay, and let's take this off. Shall we take this off? Yeah. Enjoy having a stretch of her legs. Big stretch. She will stay with her legs a little bit in this position, like the harness, for a few weeks after it comes off.
Right.
But then they will slowly come down and she will be absolutely fine. And we expect her just to develop as normal.
Okay, oh, that's good news.
So thanks so much for coming in today to show us Abby in her pelvic harness.
Oh, no worries, it was a pleasure, we had fun.
Let's get her pelvic harness back on.